I'm going to show you all the parts of the Sony high definition camcorder for the Rush Grant. It's the CX550V model. You see that right up there. Okay, and I'm going to show you, this is a top view showing the charger for it. And you see what the end of the charger looks like. So this is the AC adapter that charges up the camera. Now, the place to charge it up is right there. There's a little rubber door that opens up, and then you push that connector in to charge your camera, and it shouldn't take too long to charge it. Okay, now here's another cable that you have. This is the video cable that you plug in right above where you charge your camera up. There's another little door there, and you open it up, and this cable that has the old RCA type jacks on the end, that way you could plug it in and play your camcorder over an old analog system. So like a TV that has the old RCA jacks, you could play it on that. Okay. All right. You also, on the top of your camera, you have a connector that's made for the wireless microphone receiver, and it's the big piece that looks like this. All right. It pushes into that slot, and then you tighten this little ring here to tighten it on there, and then you turn it on the side of it. There's a switch, and then you also have earbud that you can plug in here so you can hear the person on the other end that's using the other part that I'll show you in just a second. And this is the bag that comes with it to carry everything in there. This is the remote hand control for the camera that you can start and stop remotely if you had your camera on a tripod. This is the other part of the Bluetooth remote microphone system, and this is the one that you'd clip onto your shirt, and it comes with a little wind sock, but usually that's not necessary to use that out in the wind. It'll work just fine. This also has an on-off button, and it has a little AAA battery, I believe, maybe one or two that charges it inside. And it also comes with earbuds. So in this way, you could be 60 yards away, and while your friend is filming you, you can listen and hear instructions from the videographer, and they'll also hear you with the other earbuds that we saw in the previous picture. So it's pretty neat. This is an optional cable that didn't come with your camera, but you can buy it from Amazon. And the way it works is when you open up the little door that lets you see your viewing on the monitor of the camera, there's a connector in there that uses HDMI, but it's a mini HDMI. It's not the normal HDMI that looks like this. So I bought this cable on Amazon for a few dollars, and it has the mini HDMI that plugs into your camera, and then it has the regular HDMI on the other end, so you could plug it into a high-definition TV and play content from your camera across to the high definition TV. So that's kind of neat to be able to do that. You can also buy, I bought some little adapters that will plug into the bigger HDMI, and so they're like gender benders that will convert this big regular HDMI into the smaller HDMI. So you could take a regular HDMI cable and put the little gender bender on it, and it will work with this camera. So it's kind of neat. We also have, this is one of the most important cables that comes with your camera. It's a micro USB cable. It's USB on one end, and on the other end it fits right above where we saw the HDMI mini at. It plugs in there inside the camera, and that enables you to transfer your video from the hard drive on the camera to your computer top. So that's how you do that. To do that, you have plug it in, and then you actually press on the touch screen of the monitor where it will say USB connect. And when you do that, you'll be able to browse into the folders, and you'll be able to find your movie files in there. And they're kind of layered down in the folders, but you'll find them. Just copy them across to your computer, and then you can work with them in Movie Maker on Windows 7, or you can use other programs in Windows XP. Let's see if I missed anything here. We have pretty much gone over all of the cables there, it looks like. So That's kind of, and this is another view of the analog cable that goes to the connector at the back of it, and also this important cable that I just talked about, being able to transfer your videos over directly from the hard drive. This is micro USB, and this is an analog video cable.